I want to tell you a little bit about the story about running and why I believe running is very much like running a business and what you can take up with it. And the gentleman behind me is Roger Bannister. And Roger is the first person to break the 4-minute mile. And you should make good notice of this guy because we will see him again and again throughout the presentation. To start my talk, there is a Japanese author called Haruka Murakami, who wrote a book which is called What I Talk About When I Talk About Running. And in this book, there's a very memorable quote for me, which is, to reach the finish line, never walking, and enjoying the race. These three things, in this order, are my goals. So today I want to talk to you about never walking. And to start this off with a true story, in 2008, I suffered from pretty bad depression. I was very, very depressed. I was visiting a doctor's and I took some medication, and it all didn't really help. Until I found a guy who said, what are you passionate about? And I remembered that when I was younger, I did run a lot in college and high school. And I said, running is something which I do enjoy. And he said, you should run for your life. He said, go out, run every day. It will be better. And that was 2008. Since then, I've run about 10,000 miles, 15,000 kilometers. And if you run 10,000 miles, you're on your own for a while, and you're like, running along, and I've run anything from 5K races to ultra marathons, to 50 mile races. There's a lot of stuff which goes through your head, and I find it very cleansing and very very positive. And there's a lot of things which I've thought about, and I thought, shit, you know what? Running really is a metaphor for life, but it's also a metaphor for business. And what I want to do is, I want to give you the 10 principles of running, and I want to give you an example of how these businesses apply to my business life, and I hope you can just make the connection for yourself. So, to start things off, the very first thing you need to learn is, you need to train hard. And what I found interesting was, when I started my first company, I was fresh out of university. I actually never finished my degree, which is a stupid thing, so don't do that. And I thought the world is mine. And I wasn't very well trained. I didn't really understand the world of business. I thought the stuff I read in books was actually the world. And I kind of pretty much screwed up my first company. I managed to sell it, but it was a slug. It was horrible. So really, training hard is just a starting point. You need to start somewhere, and training is your starting point. And then the second one is you make sacrifices when you are on the road and in business, right? So this guy there is Ian Suppotek. He's one of the most famous runners of all times. He's a Czech runner. And Ian was very famous for the fact of he poured his soul into running. So to win numerous races and numerous Olympic titles, he trained super, super hard. He did stuff like he ran in the winter with like really heavy boots to train his legs. And in South Life, and you all know this, right? It's the thing of like, you work through nights. You make the sacrifice. You don't meet your friends. You have to invest time into your business. And you come to this point where you make choices. And I surely made a lot of choices in my startups. And it's really important to think about to make the positive choices. And to give another example of my personal life, in my first startup, we looked for an investor, and we found a couple of them, and we looked at the term sheets. And we went with the investor who had the best term sheet. And deep in myself, I was like, I wasn't really happy with the investor. Because I didn't really think that he understood our business, and that he was a great guy, but it was the most money. So we went with that, and it was a positive choice. And it kind of screwed up my whole like startup, basically. And it was a really terrible time when we sold the startup, because it was like just ugly. So when you come to choices, really focus on like making positive ones. You have to live with these choices. So make the choices which are positive for you. And this applies to your sporting career as well. This guy there, Cassius Clay, Muhammad Ali, biggest sports star of all times, biggest ego of all times, clearly seek out his potential. And this is something you as young entrepreneurs should do as well. Figure out what are you good at and really push into this direction. Like, what is your potential? So for me, it meant I tried out in running, anything from 5Ks to 50 milers, and I found my sweet spot is half marathons, which is 13.1 miles, 23 kilometers. And that's my sweet spot, that's my potential, that's where I'm really good at. That's where I can run to my fullest potential, and I only do this amount. So go out, seek your potential, there's so much in you. I recently read a report which said that for the average athlete, so not talking like the highest pro level, but for the average athlete, there's basically an unlimited amount of betterment you can get. You can always get better. Set high goals. This is our friend Roger again. So here I tell you a funny story. So when Roger set out to beat the 4-minute mile, so running a whole mile, 1.6 kilometers in less than 4 minutes, it was considered impossible. The world basically said there were medical papers which said that the human heart will explode if you run faster than 4 miles a minute. And Roger just pushed through it. He was like, I don't care. I want to break this barrier. So he set a goal which was unattainable. He was called crazy, but he still set the goal, and he managed to break through it. Funny thing is, after he broke through this, within 3 weeks, three other people broke the 4-minute barrier. So set your goals really high. So in startup land, this means, if you think about Germany as your market or Austria or something, it's not. The world is your market. Go. Be bold. Make bold choices. Make bold decisions. My first startup, again, I only did Germany. Biggest mistake ever. Be bold. This is Shalane Flanagan. She's one of the fastest US runners. I had the privilege to see her run once. And I don't know if you see this on this picture, but she has the perfect ability to relax under pressure. She has her eyes closed while running. This is a picture of her 3,000 meter world record, where she actually overtook the runner there. So if you are in high pressure situations, and this is what you will have in your startup every day, you have to learn to relax. If you're tense, you will have a lot of bad karma, and you will like annoy your people, and you will stress out. So learn to relax under pressure. This guy, very famous in Austria. So you have to attack pain. One thing which is unavoidable when you run, regardless how far you run. So I had this from 5Ks to ultra marathons. You will come to the point where you have pain. You are in deep, deep pain, and your deepest systems will tell you, stop running. Stop it. Don't go. And you will have this in your business as well. You will wake up in the mornings and you're like, shit, I only slept three hours this night. I worked so hard on this. I can't do this anymore. You need to overcome this. Attack the pain. Pain is only a feeling. You can absolutely override it. Steve Prefontaine, one of the most courageous runners ever. One of the first runners, by the way, who was sponsored by Nike at the time. Pushing the pace. So this guy was really well known for, he went out into every race and he had the courage to race it to his best abilities from the get-go. He never held back. He always pushed. Push, push, push. It's another thing you have to do in your startup. When you get up, every single day, push the pace. Never hold back. Go, go, go. This is really important if you want to motivate your people. Like, people see that you're pushing and they will follow you. Which brings us to the next one. You have to work as a team. Remember Roger? That's Roger. The way Roger beat the 4-minute mile was, he actually worked with a team. He had two colleagues which paced him through the first and the second lap of his run. So in entrepreneurship, in your startup, you cannot be a single person. You cannot even be a single team. Try to connect with people. Try to work as a team. You're a family. Events like this are great because like people get together and share stuff. Share stuff with your peers, share stuff with other startups. See the world as a team, work with these guys, and you actually can achieve what you want to set up. Lastly, Usain Bolt, fastest man on earth. Ever, if you run a race, if you're in business, run to win. There's nothing more which pisses me off more than people who go into a marathon, into the holy grail of running, and just trot along and treat it as a festival. It's that race. The legend has that the person who ran the first marathon a Greek messenger running from Marathon to Athens to tell the Athens population about the great victory, died at the very last minute, basically, when he reached Greece. That might not be true, but this is the spirit of the marathon. You want to die in this. This is a race, right? And if you go into business, you want to win. There's nothing else but winning. So I've got two more. So 10 principles, but two more. One of the famous things which happens when you run a marathon, you will ultimately always hit the wall. This is the moment at mile 20 or 21 when you run out of your glycogen, your blood sugar, and your body will basically shut down. Your body will say, I can't go anymore. And this has happened to me in business with every single of my ventures. Every time I did a business, I woke up one morning and I was like, shit, it's over. I can't do this anymore. I'm tired, I'm not successful, like the world is against me, everyone hates me, I'm out of money, I'm eating ramen for the last 5 days. The wall will come, and your perseverance is necessary. And you can overcome this wall. It's like, fight through this 1 mile in a marathon. It's like, you run through this 1 mile, and suddenly you have second wind. And in business, it's the same thing. If you stand up that morning, and you go to your office, and you push the pace, and you run hard, you will get through that wall, trust me. And lastly, Haile Gebrselassie. Until very recently, the fastest marathon on the world, still one of the most inspiring athletes on the world. The essence of building a business is relentless focus and boring consistency. Relentless focus, you must make the main thing the main thing. You will come to so many choices and so many things you could do and so many, you know, beautiful opportunities you see, but you have to focus on the one thing you want to build. And that can change over time, but you have to make the main thing, otherwise it will like just blow your capacity against like too many things you can do. And then, once you hit this main thing, it's consistency. The teams which win are the teams which basically set out to do the same thing, and every morning they slave away and make this thing their main thing and they get it done. So with that, these are the 12 rules. So, anything from train hard, make sacrifices, to positive change, to live up to your potential, reach for high goals, relax under pressure, attack pain, remember Arnold, pushing the pace, working as a team, and hitting the wall, and lastly, relentless focus on boring consistency. With this comes one rule, for me, one single rule. And actually, if you ever watched the movie Fight Club, there's not one rule, there's two rules. They're the same. You have to have fun. If you don't run with a big grin on your face, you will not be successful. If you don't do your business every single day with like at least this little glimpse of like, hey, I actually enjoy this. Even if it's sucky, even if I hit the ball at 21 miles, even if I don't want to do this, the hard work, you still have this smile on your face, then you are onto something. So remember, reaching the goal, never walking, having fun in the race, that's the three things in this order. So with that, I just wanted to say, never walk, never accept to walk, always run. I've got this as my life motto. When I read the book, this was the thing which jumped at me. And you know, my blog is called Never Walk. I tell everyone to never walk. Walking is for like people who work in companies. That's not you. So with that, I leave you. And if you ever want to run with me, send me an email, find me on Twitter. I'm based in California. I'm super happy to take you out there. If you ever want to race with me, I encourage you to do so. It spurs me on. And if you have any questions, please fire them to me. Thank you.
So, thank you very much.